Hey, what's up, guys? I hope you're doing okay. Welcome back to my channel. Today we are going to be making honeycomb. Look at that, man. Oh my god. It's not that good, but it's super fun to make. So here's how we do it. First, you want to start with some light corn syrup. This is going to be our highlighted ingredient of the day. And we're going to start by combining everything in a saucepan. To the saucepan, we are going to add 2 tablespoons of cold water. Apparently, like, it's cold, so I just got mine from the fridge. That's why it's in a glass, obviously. And into that, we are going to add some corn syrup. So I have light corn syrup. As I've mentioned before, it has added vanilla, so I don't know. I don't think it adds any flavor. Even though it says it has vanilla, I don't taste it at all. Anyways, we are going to add 3 tablespoons of corn syrup. And then, in addition to the corn syrup, we're going to add 1/2 cup of white granulated sugar. Then we're going to mix that around just a little bit. Then we're going to put it onto a stove that is not preheated, but it has a medium-high heat flame, I guess, is a way to put it. I finally have, like, a candy thermometer. Thanks, Mom. I appreciate it. Because she noticed I've been working with a lot of sugars recently. So we are actually going to get this to the hard crack stage. I cannot remember the temperature. I will put it on screen real quick. That's the temperature where we have to get this candy to, the sugar to. As you can see, I'm kind of zooming in on it just a tiny bit. On the left side of the screen, you can see these sugar crystals forming. I was lazy. I'm pretty sure this was like at 11 o'clock because I was just bored. So I was like, I'm gonna make some honeycomb. And I should have been brushing down the sides of the pan with some water, with just a little, you know, just a brush that you would use for, like, barbecue sauce. If you're barbecuing, you just use that to wipe down the sides with just some water, because that ends up burning and ruining the flavor of my honeycomb. It still looks cool, it's still really fun to make, but as you can see, right there, it's starting to turn brown. I don't think that's supposed to happen in the original recipe, but over time it does kind of make all of my sugar taste burnt, and I don't know if you've had burnt sugar before. I do not recommend it. It tastes horrible. Honestly, it tastes like, my brother said it tasted like campfire, like burnt campfire marshmallows. So if you like that, definitely burn your sugar. Anyways, as you can see, it's burned quite a bit. Into our saucepan, we are going to add our baking powder. The baking powder is going to make it all fluffy. As you can see, it's fluffing up really fast. So fast and just so fluffy that I actually had to ask my dad to grab the camera while I was rushing over to pour it into a prepared baking sheet that is lined with parchment paper. I thought it would have come out a little bigger, so that's why I have a huge baking dish. But you should probably use like an 8x8 square glass dish. That's what I would have used if I knew that it was going to be this small. Anyways, when this is cooling, while this is cooling, you do not want to flatten it or smooth it out. You just want to leave it how it is, because if you do, you will ruin all the little air cavities, the little pockets of air that form the honeycomb texture. Is that making sense? I'm pretty sure that's making sense. So you just want to leave it as is. And as I said before, if you're trying to clean all the stuff that's covered in sugar, hot water will help everything. Even if you don't have hot water, leave it in the kitchen overnight filled with just cold water or just tap water, and leave it in the sink, obviously, and it should be good and cleaned up by morning. So it's starting to form like a skin type thing. So that's really cool. As you can see, it's hardening sugar. It's gonna do that. So after about 20 minutes, I got impatient. The original recipe that will be in the description said to let it cool for about 30 to 45 minutes. I should have followed that, as my first cut is very, very sad. Anyways, this is what it looks like. It did flatten a bit, as expected, obviously. I did want it to stay that big fluffy, but obviously it's not going to, so that's a little sad. As I said, I was very excited to cut into this, but it was not a crispy cut for the first time because it was not done. So when I cut into it, as you can see, I was looking at it and I was like, shoot, did I do something wrong? It's stretchy because it didn't harden all like all the way through the middle, so that kind of sucks. So I let it sit on the counter for about 5 to 10 more minutes, and then I felt it and I was like, oh my god, the ends are like perfect. It was like fresh bread. You know how you can crunch it? You know that scene in Ratatouille where she's like, this is what bread is supposed to smell like and sound like? That's what it sounded like. Anyways, this was my first block of honeycomb that I broke off. It's small, definitely. The holes of the honeycomb part were not as big as I thought, and I was like, crap, I messed it up, because all the pictures that I seen, they were like, it looked like honeycomb. So I decided to take a big chunk out of the middle and kind of just go that way, and oh my god, I did it on my first try. I don't know if that's like a big thing, or it's like, oh my god, you got it on your first try, or if this is like a basic thing to do, but I was absolutely jazzed. Is that a thing people say? Bringing it back. I'm bringing it back. So I just continued breaking up the honeycomb, just showing the camera all the pieces, even though basically it's the same thing every single time. But I was just so excited because it looked exactly how it did in everybody else's videos and, you know, pictures and little TikToks and everything. Anyways, I'm so super excited. I did not like it because it tasted burnt, but I put it in my tea. It's amazing because it's still sugar. At the end of the day, it's still sugar. So I just add one into my tea. I put it in this cute little jar. Oh my god. And yeah, that's how you make honeycomb. That was my journey of making honeycomb, at least. I hope you try it out. You know, it's fun. It's fun. Doesn't taste good, at least my burnt version of it. I'll probably try again, but this one did not taste good. Looked cool though. Anyways, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did enjoy it, make sure to leave a like and comment and subscribe. Tell me what I should make next. Yeah, cool. I hope you guys stay well, and I will see you guys in the next video. Bye!